Alabama. Time to schedule your vasectomy?
That's if a bill introduced in the state legislature become law.
Laid out in a simple three-page document is legislation that could mandate a medical procedure for men. State Representative Rolanda Hollis's bill would require a man to get a vasectomy within 1 month of his 50th birthday or the birth of his third child.
Yo, YouTube, what's going on? Trey back again to hit you with another video. Now, I'm sorry that I'm a few days late for this video, but I did not know that this happened. And this story comes out of Montgomery, Alabama. Big shout to everybody in that Bama. And I'm talking about Alabama, not that Bama weed y'all be smoking. But anyway, it's a sad story. And this is not for the ladies, really. This is for the men. So my men, you all gather around. That's some shit going down in town. And let me tell you about what's really going on. Now, out of all days, they decide to try to pass this law on Valentine's Day. Out of all damn days, I guess the legislature never sleeps. But anyway, you have an Alabama state representative, goes by the name of Rolanda Hollis, and she looked like somebody that would be glad to snip your balls off. Yes, this is not going to be grown folks talk, but this is going to be some real ass talk right here. Because one thing that we men, that we must cherish and possess is our family jewels. Now, let me get this straight also. Now, I don't believe in men having children just for the hell of it. I believe if you have a child, you're supposed to take care of your child. So let's get that straight also. But don't nobody have a right to come snip and tuck your ass. You know what I'm saying? I'm not talking about your butt cheeks. I'm talking about your ball sack. But anyway, now, this woman, Ms. Representative Hollis, says that they are trying to force a vasectomy at the age of 50 or men who have three kids in Alabama. And the lawmaker trying to do her best to push this into law. Now, you all let me know what you all think about this, because I'm glad that I do not live in Alabama. And no offense to anybody that lives there, but this is some bullshit. You would think that we have enough going on in the world with the coronavirus, with the Budweiser virus, with the flu, with all kinds of other shit going on. But anyway, I'm going to read a quick snippet from this story, and I'm going to give my opinion. Surely, as we go, an Alabama lawmaker has proposed a bill that will require a man to undergo a vasectomy at age 50 or after he has fathered a specific number of children. Well, what about all these damn women having all these damn children? I know I got a lot of women following me. Some of them probably got about 4, 5, 10 kids. No offense to you all, but what I'm trying to say is this. If a woman can't tell a man what to do with his body, a man should be able to tell a woman what to do with their body. That's true. This sounds like some retaliation stuff right here, so let's go a little deeper. But anyway, the bill is known by HB 238. When I heard of HB, I thought about it. It must have been his balls, 238. But anyway, it was filed by Representative Rolanda Harris, a Democrat from Birmingham, out of all places. Let's see what Ricky Smiley has to say about this. But anyway, it will require a man to undergo a vasectomy after the birth of his third biological child. They're trying to do it like China, where you're going to have 1 or 2 damn kids. If you have more than that, they're going to arrest you, fine you, probably cut your whole ball sack off. But anyway, now this is after his third biological child, or within 1 month of his 50th birthday. Damn, you can't even enjoy all the way up to your 50. They're going to snip and tuck before you turn 50. That's some bullshit right there. Like, what do we have to look forward to in this damn country? I mean, damn, ain't we already going through enough? But anyway, let's continue. The bill also says the procedure will be done at the man's own expense. You mean to tell me you're going to force to get my stuff snipped and then you're going to force me to pay? That sounds like some child support shit where the child ain't even yours and they try to get you to pay for it. But anyway, let's go on. Now, under existing law, there are no restrictions on the reproduction rights of men according to the text of the bill. And that's the problem right there. That's where the boy cackety cack cack come in at. This was back in 2019. When they passed this bill, what it's saying, they're making it illegal for a woman to have a damn abortion no matter if it's incest, no matter if she got raped or not. Now, I believe one thing. If you have got raped or you got pregnant, you should be able to abort the child. It's no telling what you're bringing into this world. I mean, don't you all watch ID Channel and Oxygen Channel? You might be bringing a little demon in the world. We already got enough demons as it is. Let's continue. But anyway, now, Hollis said many opponents have seen her bill as an outrageous overstep. Yes, it is an overstep. You're overstepping people's balls and boundaries. But anyway, but she counters. Year after year, the majority party continues to introduce new legislation that tries to detect a woman's body in her reproductive rights. This sounds like some retaliation, some get back stuff like, you hit me, I hit you back. Let me tell you this right here. Now, no offense. Don't a woman have a power over her body for us like in any other state? But don't she have a power over her body to say, well, look, I want to have this baby now or go get an abortion? A man don't have that power. So let's get that straight also. But anyway, let's continue. Now, she says also that the new legislation that tries to dictate a woman's body in her reproductive rights. Hollis calls her bill a means to neutralize, neutralize, all right, neutralize your ball sack last year's abortion ban bill and to send a message that men should not be legislating what women do with their bodies. So why in the hell would you legislate what a man should do with his body? I mean, come on, y'all. That sounds like a pot calling the kettle black, white, purple, pink, whatever. Anyway, let's go on and finish up. Hollis was referring to a near total abortion ban law that passed both Republican-controlled chambers of the Alabama legislature and was signed by Republican Governor Kay Ivey soon afterward in 2019. That's when all the hell broke loose. The law has no exceptions for rape and incest and would make performing an abortion at any stage of pregnancy a felony unless the mother's health is in danger. Now, I believe if you got raped, like I said earlier, you shouldn't have the child. You know, if you don't want to have a child, I'm sure no woman in her right mind that got raped would want to have a child. But to sit up here and say that men should follow the same procedures just because they did this to women, that's totally not right. I mean, damn, if I was a man, I would move the hell up out of Alabama because this sounds like what's yet to come. Now, let's go and finish up. But anyway, it was designed as a direct child to Roe versus Wade. Alabama's law was blocked by a federal judge in October. And I bet there's a lot of happy females in Alabama that's like, woo! Because I know a few of them can't wait to get rid of their damn child. Anyway, let's go and finish. Now, Hollis' bill was introduced to the House on Thursday and referred to the House Judiciary Committee. It was filed the same day HB 248 was filed. And that stands for His Balls Part 1. His Balls 238 was filed by Hollis later on. So they trying to snip and tuck. I mean, damn, what the hell is going on? Now, this bill also known as the Born Alive bill. I don't believe his name was Born Alive. I believe his name is His Balls. It was introduced in the Alabama House. That bill will require a physician to exercise reasonable care to save a child born alive after an abortion or attempted abortion. So they don't believe in no damn abortions. So what's going on? I mean, what, you trying to lock all the damn kids up? I believe one thing, you know, now me technically, my beliefs are my beliefs, but I don't really believe in abortions. But I believe one thing, if you lay down and you make a child, you should be able to take care of your child. And I understand people's financial situations and what they go through and also what may have transpired with them having a child. But at the same time, if you're grown, you should be responsible for your body and also a child. But to sit up here and say that men should follow suit just because women almost had this bill passed on them is very wrong. I mean, what kind of person in their right mind would think of something like that? Like, that come from Satan himself. I don't even think the devil could think of nothing like that. But to say that men should have a vasectomy by age 50 or by their third child is very overstepped. For Representative Rolanda Hollis to say this is very outrageous and also shows really where she is. It's like a tit for tat. But one thing they don't tell you about is the side effects of having a vasectomy. And for those of you all who have had vasectomies, I mean, number one, I heard it makes you have bad acne. It gives you all kinds of headache, make you nauseous. Not only are you sterile, but also it makes you have erectile dysfunction where you don't get it up. So really, you're going to be catching hell for the rest of your damn life after you reach a certain age if you get a vasectomy. And this is not for everybody. It's just for the majority of the people. But you all let me know what you think about this, because it's a sad situation where we have people dictating other people's livelihoods like it's some kind of game. Just because they try to pass a law on women, do they give Representative Rolanda Hollis the right to sit up here and say that men should follow suit with a HB 238 bill, which stands for His Balls 238. So my people in Alabama, beware, hit me up in the comment section. Let me know what you all think about this. And if you like the video, push that like button. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel. Definitely share this video with your family and friends. Till next time, you all stay blessed. Watch your back, watch your front, cover your ass, and grab your balls, say, because they coming forward. But anyway, I'm out.